Hello everyone, in this video we are going to learn about Visual Basic Editor, the very basics of where we are going to do our coding. Now, I showed you all how to get the developer tab. Now from the developer tab, there are two ways on how we can open the Visual Basic Editor. The first one being the Visual Basics. Just clicking on this, you get a window. Now this window is Visual Basic for Applications, which is VBA, where we are going to do our coding. Another option is by using the shortcut, which is Alt F11 for the Windows users. So Alt F11 and I get the window. So this is the VBA window where we are going to do our coding. Now it looks really blank and black, whereas we can add more features to it. So the two most important windows basically which we are going to add is the properties and the Project Explorer. So just copy this slide please. We can resize this particular tab also, window also, just, you know, it's simple to and why do we resize? I'll show you all. Suppose this is my Excel view. Now this particular Excel sheet which I'm having over here, we call this as Excel view, and this is our Visual Basic Editor where we do the coding. Now suppose I can resize this particular window, and why do we do this? Basically, we do this so that whatever input, whatever codes we are going to write over here, when we run that code, we can see what all is happening on the Excel view directly, instead of, you know, again and again by minimizing this particular window and again opening the Excel view. So you can just simply have it on the same desktop. So this is done. I can resize my editor. For the time being, let us keep it as the full screen. Now the two windows which I was talking about, so the platform where we can create, edit and delete the codes for macros, we need to perform a specific task where we do all these things are done on the Visual Basic Editor. Now Project Explorer and Properties window, there are two methods. First of all, we can use View Project Explorer, which or the shortcut key Control plus R for the Windows. For the Mac users, I have written it over here. So the for the Mac users, you can use this particular Control plus Command plus R key. Properties window, View and Properties window, or the F4 shortcut key. So this is my Visual Basic Editor. I will click on View Project Explorer, or you can click on the Control plus R shortcut. Again, I'll click on View. Basically, this is my project window where you can see your all the projects are saved over here. We'll discuss about this. Then we'll get the properties window, and I can just drag this down. So the first thing which I'm So basically these were the two windows, and there appears a window on the left which can see, and the coding is to be done on the right side, which we are going to add a coding screen over here, and then we'll do the coding over there. So these are the two basic windows, project and the properties window, which we are going to use a lot. And it's generally these windows are not all generally closed. You'll have to open this window when you're using your VBA for the first time. And once if I have opened these two windows, I don't have to open it again and again each time when I open my VBA. Once I close this window and again I try to open the VBA editor, then at that point of time I'll again have to open both of it. So I'll use Control plus R for the properties, and I'll use F4 for the properties, and project for Control plus R for the project window. So this is how I get my windows. Now the next thing which we are going to do is the objects. Now VBA is not object oriented. We did it in our second class that Visual Basic is the object oriented programming language. Whereas VBA is not object oriented, but it deals with a lot of objects like tools and contain data. So as you all can see, Microsoft Excel objects, these are the objects on which we do the coding. And so the first thing which I am going to show you is the worksheet object. The main Excel sheet, to go to the main Excel sheet, which was the Excel view I was talking about, you can just click on this green key which you can see over here and you go to the main Excel view. Or you can use again Alt F11. You can use Alt F11. Again, you can use Alt F11 to go to the Excel view. So Alt F11 is a useful shortcut, you know, to go between Excel view and the VB editor. I'll just again show you all Alt plus F11 to go to the Excel view. The next thing which we have is, if we add sheets to the Excel, more sheets will be added to the Excel, Microsoft Excel objects. Currently, this Microsoft Excel objects, this workbook contains three sheets currently. Sheet 1, Sheet 2, Sheet 3. By default, which is open for all the workbooks, three sheets are by default open when you open a workbook. Now suppose if I open my, I'll use Alt F11 and I'll just add one more sheet, going back to the editor, and you can see sheet 4 has been added. Also, one more thing, if I rename this particular sheet, let us rename it to be demo. I've renamed sheet 1 as demo, and again going back to the VBA, you can see sheet 1 demo. So this signifies that you have renamed your sheet 1 as demo. So this is how renaming a sheet, deleting a sheet, adding more sheets, you can increase, decrease or change the name of the Microsoft Excel objects from here in the Visual Basic Editor as well. The next thing, if you rename the sheet which we saw currently in the Excel view, it will get changed in the VB editor under the objects as well. This workbook, which signifies the basically which workbook you're working on. So basically I haven't saved any name for the workbook. This workbook signifies that you're working on which particular workbook. So this is the workbook. You can change the name of the workbook from the properties window. Let's say suppose I make it VBA class. I'll just go to the naming conventions in the later classes, but just to show you all why this error is coming, not a legal object name, because I have added a space. Whereas for a name in VBA, you can't add a space. So I'll just make it VBA underscore class. Now this has been accepted and I've changed the workbook name to be VBA class. So basically I've showed you all the Microsoft Excel objects, how we can add, delete more sheets, rename more sheets from the Excel view and automatically it gets changed over here, and how can you change the name from the properties window. Now this properties window is very important. We'll go into depth in the later classes. Basically this is arranged in alphabetical order. These are all categorized and we are going to learn about it when we are going to learn about the modules. So this is the basic interface of a VBA editor. I hope you all have started enjoying this, because this is going to be really amazing and we are going to make it very, very interesting for you all.